Welcome to the course, Formal Language and Automata Theory. In this lecture, we will discuss about normal forms for context-free grammars. In this, the first topic, simplification or minimization of context-free grammar. So this is the first topic in fourth unit. So normal forms for context-free grammar. First here we will discuss about eliminating useless symbols, then eliminating epsilon productions or null productions, followed by normal forms for context-free grammar. The first one is Chomsky normal form. The second one is called as Grebeck normal form. Now we will discuss one by one related to normal forms for context-free grammar. Later, we will discuss about the pumping lemma for context-free language, closer properties of context-free languages. Then, end of this chapter, we will discuss about the Turing machine introduction. Now, let us come to the agenda of today's topic. First, here, we will discuss about the simplification or minimization of context-free grammar. Here we have two methods for simplification or minimization: by eliminating useless symbols, then by eliminating epsilon production. Then we can convert a context-free grammar into Chomsky normal form and Grebeck normal form after simplification only. So now let us see the introduction about normal forms for context-free grammar. In context-free grammar, there are two normal forms, just now we mentioned. The first one is Chomsky normal form, abbreviated as CNF. Wherever CNF means, that is Chomsky normal form. Second one, Grebeck normal form, that is called as GNF. Wherever GNF occurred, that is nothing but a Grebeck normal form. To convert a context-free grammar into any normal form, the context-free grammar does not contain the following things. So to convert a context-free grammar into any normal form, the context-free grammar does not contain the first one: variables not deriving terminal string. In the given grammar productions, left-hand side of each and every production, it contains a variable. That variable contains some productions. So each and every variable must derive some terminal strings, combination of E in the grammar definition, G equal to VTSP, T closure, string of terminals, compulsory. So variables not deriving terminal string. If any variable not deriving a terminal string, irrespective of by substituting its equivalent production, that variable not included in the context-free grammar. Second condition, symbols not appearing in any sentential form. Symbols means the variables that does not occur in any sentential form at the time of derivation. Those symbols called as useless symbols. In any production, in any derivation, a particular symbol is not occurred or not used anywhere in the derivation, then that symbol or those symbols called as useless symbols. Then any production or productions consisting of those useless symbols, then those productions called as useless productions. So these type of symbols also we have to remove in any context-free grammar context. The first one, variables not deriving a terminal string. Such variables we have to identify and remove from the grammar production. Then the symbols not appear anywhere in the sentential form, means in the derivation. Those symbols you can identify, which is called as useless symbols. And the productions are called as useless productions. We have to remove both the useless symbols and useless productions. Then third one, null productions. If any grammar contains null productions, how to define a null production? So suppose, for example, A derives epsilon or lambda. Left hand side, any variable. Right hand side, if it contains a single epsilon or lambda, then that is called as a null production. These type of productions needs to be removed from the given context-free grammar. Next, fourth one, in any context-free grammar, if any of the productions are of the form A derives B. Here B is a single variable in the right hand side. Left hand side, anyway, it must start with a single variable. But for example, only we consider A derives B. Any production, right hand side, if it contains a single variable, then that is called as unit production. So these type of productions also needs to be eliminated if a context-free grammar contains. Now, the process of eliminating all the above four steps, 1 to 4, is called as simplification or minimization of context-free grammar. So what is meaning of simplification or minimization of a context-free grammar means? So you need to eliminate all the above four points. The first one is variables not deriving terminal string. We have to remove those type of variables. Then symbols not appearing in any sentential form while deriving a string or the process of derivation. Those symbols called as useless symbols, then the productions associated with those useless symbols called as useless productions also needs to be removed. Then third one, null productions are denoted by a null value in the right hand side of a production, a single null, that is denoted by epsilon or lambda. So these productions also eliminated. Then productions of the form A derives B, right hand side, a single variable. So these type of productions are called as unit productions. So we have to remove unit productions also. Now the process of eliminating all the above 1 to 4 steps is called simplification or minimization of a context-free grammar. Now we will discuss how to remove all these four step points in any given context-free grammar if it contains. For that, we will use some techniques. One of the most useful technique is called as a useful substitution rule. So for all cases, the substitution rule is used. So how to define the substitution rule? Let us see the definition. So let G equal to VTSV be a context-free grammar. Suppose that P contains, P means productions. Productions of the form A derives X1 B X2. Here X1 and X2 are string of variables or terminal combinations, whereas B is a variable. Assume that A, which is on left hand side, and B, which is in the right hand side, middle of X1 and X2. Are different variables. A and B are different. And B contains a production like B derives Y1 or Y2 and so on Yn. So B consisting of N productions. So that is the set of all productions in P, which have B as the left side. So now here a production of A is given, then productions of B also given. Now, how to define a substitution rule? Here you can see. Let us say G dash is another new grammar, which can be defined as VTSP dash. So all tuples except p dash are same as g. Only productions are changed. So be the grammar in which p dash is constructed. How to construct p dash of g dash? By deleting a dash x1 b x2. We have to delete the productions of a from p and adding to it. So by deleting a productions means in the right hand side, b variable is substituted by its all corresponding productions that can be added to p dash. Now you can see, and adding to it a derives. Here you can see x1, x2. Actually, this is b. But what b contains? B contains y1, y2, and so on, yn. First, we substituted y1, the first b value. Then it contains b y2 also. Second time, we substituted again b value, second production, y2. Then third time, we substituted b productions, third value, and so on. And so on. The last production of b, that is yn, is substituted in place of b. Here you can observe x1, x2 are same in all productions. Only b value is changed. First b value y1, second b value y2, third b value y3, and so on, n b value yn are substituted. Now this is the new production of a. This can be added to p dash of g dash. Then the two languages obtained from both grammars are equal. That is, L of g dash equal to L of p. So this is called as a substitution rule. Now let us see one example. For any given grammar, let g equal to a comma b. These are all the variables capital V. Now terminals are a, b, c. Now vt s is a. Now p production. Now and p is given by p is given by the following production. A derives terminal A or terminal string AA or a variable A followed by terminals AB followed by the variable B and terminal C. Now B derives terminal string ABB followed by variable A followed by B. Now you have to apply the substitution rule for this. See here, first we will consider the starting variable production. Here the starting variable is A. So A derives A or AAA or ABBC. So now in S productions, wherever we have substitution, that you can substitute. See the second production B. B is occurred in the right hand side of A production. Here B is there. Now in place of B, you can substitute these two productions related to B. Now here first we will get G dash equal to same variables you will get, same terminals you will get. Then starting variable also same. Now productions are changed. Now where p dash is constructed by removing a productions, and you can add a productions after substituting b production values in a, that can be added to p dash. Therefore p dash is now a derives a or AAA then A, B, here B production. So here you can see, first, let us say this is B1 value, this is B2 value. So here you can substitute B1, then again A, B, B2, C. Now this will becomes A derives A or AAA, AB. Now what is B1? Nothing but ABBA. ABBA. This here remains same. Now here AB, what is B2? Terminal B. Now C remains same. So now this is equivalent production obtained after applying substitution rule. Now this is G dash. So like that we have to apply a useful substitution rule. For all cases, this technique is used. So now this is one of the technique of simplification of a context-free grammar. So now we will see how to remove one by one as per the above four points we mentioned. The first point we will discuss in this class, removing useless productions. Useless production. So how to remove useless productions? First, we have to identify useless variable. So we already mentioned the first point. In any grammar, if any variable not used anywhere in the derivation or any variable that is not deriving a terminal string, so those can be called as useless variables. Then any production is combination of those useless variables. Those are all called as useless production. Then we have to remove such type of variables and productions. So here, the productions from a grammar, productions from a grammar that can never take, that can never take part in any derivation. In any derivation called useless productions. This is the definition of useless productions. The productions from a grammar that can never take part in any derivation called as useless productions. For example, let us consider S derives AS, BS, or C or null, then C derives AC. Here you can observe in this example, the production S derives capital C variable is useless production. How can we say this is useless production? The reason you can see, since C can't derive any terminal string, any terminal string. See, how can you say it is not deriving a terminal string? You can start the C productions. C derives AAC. Here the substitution is possible only in C. Again, what is C? AAC only. Here again you will get C. Again this C you can replace it by AC. See, like that every time C is repeated. C does not contains a single terminal value or null. Therefore, it can never derive a terminal string. Always it is combination of a string followed by a variable. So which is not a terminal string because it contains a variable, which is not a terminal string. Therefore, C is a useless variable. Then the productions associated with C. What are the productions here? We have S derives C, then C derives AC, or useless productions. So we have to remove all this. Why? Because S is associated with C, that is a useless variable. C anyway, that is useless. Then all these productions are removed. Then the final grammar, after removing these useless productions, the final grammar is it contains the remaining productions, that is S derives AS BS, S derives AS BS. Now S derives C is removed. Now S derives null. Now C productions nowhere. So this is the final grammar with final productions. Then you may raise one question. Again, S is useful or useless? You can start deriving some string from S. S derives AS BS. Now here are two variables. S is repeated. In place of S, you may substitute null. Suppose here, if you can put null, now B, S. Here, what is the substitution we use? S derives null. Similarly, one more S is there, A, B. Here you can substitute null. Again, S derives null. Now see, A, B. Completely, this is a terminal string. Even a single terminal or terminal string. So S is useful. So we can't say S is useless. Only S derives C, C derives AC, or useless productions. Those are removed. So like that, in any given grammar, if it contains useless productions, you can remove. That is the first method of simplification of a context-free grammar. Now, how can you define this one? While coming to formal definition, let G equal to VTSP be a context-free grammar, a variable, let us say capital A, belongs to V, is said to be useful. Is said to be useful. If and only if there is at least one string W belongs to L of G such that S derives, let us say XAY derives W. So here, when you can say a variable A is useful, so A contains some derivation or some productions. Those can be substituted in the process of derivation by applying 0, 1 or more substitutions. Finally, you will derive a string, a terminal string. So in the process of deriving terminal string, here you can see A is used. Therefore, A is said to be useful. Suppose A is never used in the process of derivation, then we can say A is useless variable. Then the productions associated with A are called as useless production. There are two aspects regarding to usefulness. Regarding to usefulness. That means how to identify a variable which is useful. The following two aspects we have to consider. The first one is some string must be derived. Must be derived from the variable A. So any variable that must and should derives a terminal string or a single terminal. This is the first condition needs to be satisfied. Then the variable A must occur in some string derived from the starting variable. Yes. In the previous example, we discussed it. Here, S is the starting variable, derives in the derivation, a variable A is occurred, is the second aspect. Now, let us see one example problem. How to identify useless symbols, then useless productions, then how to remove. So in examination, sometimes they will give questions like this. The question is, eliminate useless symbols and useless productions. And useless productions for CFG G, that is G equal to VTSP, where variables are V equal to S, A, B, C. All are uppercase letters are the variables. Terminals are small a comma small b. Now the productions are given. The productions are S derives AS or A or C comma. The second production capital A derives terminal A. Third production capital B derives terminal string AA. Then capital C derives AC. These are all the productions of the grammar. So now, how to solve this problem? Solution. Step one, what you have to do? Identify the productions that lead to a terminal string. That means which are deriving a terminal string. Identify the productions that lead to terminal string. That means that derives from the given set of productions. Which are the productions that derives a terminal string? So that is, first you can see A derives terminal A, directly it contains a terminal. Then B derives AA, directly it contains a terminal string. Now, S also, if you can take S derives A, variable A. From this, S derives A. Now A, we have the terminal A. Now you can substitute here. Now see, S also derives a terminal string. These three productions leading to terminal string. That is step one. Then step two, eliminate the variables that can't be reached from the start variable. Eliminate the variables that cannot be reached from start variable. What is the meaning of this? That is yes. That means a variable that is not derived from S. So those type of variables also you need to remove. Here you can observe from the given grammar, S derives the productions are S productions, AS, RA, RC. S is the start variable. The variables which are not derived from S, here you can see, if you can see the dependency, here the variables are S, A, B, C. Now you can see S to S, this is the starting variable on input A. Here you can see S is reachable from S. Then A is also reachable from S. Then C is also reachable from S. But here you can see B is not reachable from S. In S productions, the variable B is not there. Not reachable. From S. S is the starting variable. Therefore, here you will get S derives AS, S derives A. Then S derives C also. But S not derives B. So variable B is not reachable from starting variable S. So B is removed. B is removed. Now B and all of the productions associated with B, even after deriving a terminal string, this is not reachable. So you can remove B productions. Therefore, the remaining productions are, so what are the remaining productions after removing B? The first one, S derives AS, RA, RC, then A derives A, then C derives AC. Now you can see B derives A is removed. Again, check again now, C derives AC. Check whether it derives terminal string or not. C derives AC. A, again C means AC. Again AA, AC. So, not derives terminal string. The first condition. S not deriving a terminal string, but S is reachable. C is not deriving a terminal string, but C is reachable from S. But both conditions needs to be satisfied. But here it is not deriving a terminal string. Therefore, remove C productions. Remove all C productions. Now, what are the C productions here? Therefore, S derives C and C derives KC or removed. Then, therefore, the final grammar after removing these two, the final grammar is, now what you will get? S derives AS or A. Now S derives C is removed. Then A derives A. Now you can see. Finally, again you can verify the two conditions are satisfying or not. So here S derives AS. Then A, suppose S has A. If you can substitute, S derives A. Now A, if you can substitute A as terminal A. S deriving terminal string. By default, S is starting variable. So it can be reached by itself. Now second one, A derives A. Here terminal is derived. And A is reachable from S. So why? Because we have S derives A relationship. So both conditions are satisfied. Now, in this grammar, all the variables and all the productions are useful. There are no useless symbols and useless productions. This is the final grammar after removing useless symbols and useless productions. So like that, in any given grammar, if it consisting of useless symbols and useless productions, by using this method, you can remove. The two aspects you need to verify. Some string must be derived from a variable, each and every variable. Then the variable must and should occur in some string derived from S. Nothing but reachable from the starting variable. So like that, we have to eliminate useless symbols and useless productions for the given context-free grammar.